Good afternoon. Can I remind members of the COVID-related measures that are in place and that face coverings should be worn when moving around the Chamber and across the Holyrood campus? The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. Our time for reflection leader today is Father Jim Duggan, Parish Priest, St Charles Roman Catholic Church, Paisley.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, for inviting me to lead the time for reflection. Recently, I was making a choice between two good but different possibilities for my work. Discerning what might be the right choice to make, I spoke with a few people, to my best friend, to a colleague who runs Net Scotland, a youth ministry we founded, and to my spiritual director, a Franciscan friar of the Renewal, who daily at their soup kitchen helps people whose life circumstances are extremely challenging. It struck me how good it is to be part of a community of people with different perspectives who support and inspire me, and how amazing it is, after almost 30 years as a priest, still to have various exciting and interesting opportunities ahead. This makes me grateful for the choices that others have made that benefited me and let me have dreams and aspirations. As an adopted child, for my birth mother, who made an extremely difficult choice for the good of her son. For my mum and dad, who gave me a loving home, who nurtured me and who supported me always. For the educators who saw where my talents lay and guided me. For the church that helped me to see, in the words of St. John Henry Cardinal Newman, that God has created me to do him some definitive service. He has committed some work to me, which he has not committed to another. I have my mission. And I'm grateful for the choices which I believe created a person-centred, high-quality education system, and that supported the opportunities that arose from it, that enabled people from a modest background like my own to grow up with dreams and with the hope that those dreams could become the reality. One of the things that really saddens me is when I've seen young people without hope, who have no notion of their own goodness, of what they have to offer, and who don't live in an environment where they can aspire to the kinds of things I could when growing up. But I am heartened that having the Scottish Parliament means that our country has a committed community of people with different perspectives working to support, inspire and encourage those young people and all people in our country to have dreams and to strive to fulfil them.
Thank you, Father Duggan.